The author says الحساب, the reckoning. والحساب حق, the reckoning is true. وهو عرض أعمال العباد عليهم, it is the display of the slaves' deeds to them. It is displaying the slaves' deeds to them. ويكون بتكليم الله للعباد جميعهم, and it would be by God speaking to the slaves, all of them. يعني the word حساب refers to two things. One word refers to two things. One of those two is the presentation of the deeds, and the other is God speaking to the slaves, making them hear his speech. فيفهمون من كلام الله السؤال عما فعلوا بالنعم التي أعطاهم الله إياها. And so they understand from God's speech the questioning about what they did with the endowments that Allah gave them. فيسر المؤمن التقي. So then the God-fearing believer will be happy. ولا يسر الكافر, and the blasphemer will not be happy. لأنه لا حسنة له في الآخرة, because he won't have any good deeds in the afterlife. بل يكاد يغشاه الموت, rather he would be on the verge of dying. This means he'll never die, but if he could, he would. فقد ورد في الحديث الصحيح, it did come in the authentic hadith, ما منكم من أحد إلا سيكلمه ربه يوم القيامة. There's not one of you but that his Lord shall speak to him on resurrection day. ليس بينه وبينه ترجمان, without an interpreter between him and him. رواه أحمد وترمذي. That's narrated by Ahmad and at-Tirmidhi. Between him and him means between God and the slave. الشرح, the explanation is أن الناس, the explanation is الناس يوم القيامة تعرض عليهم أعمالهم, that the people on resurrection day, their deeds shall be displayed to them. كل معه كتابه الذي كتب فيه ما عمل. Everyone shall have his book, shall be given his book, in which what he did will be written. ويسمعون كلام الله الأزلي الذي لا يشبه كلام العالمين. And they hear the speech of God, the eternal speech of God that does not resemble the speech of creatures. كما قال أبو حنيفة, like Abu Hanifa said, الله يتكلم بلا آلة ولا حرف. Allah speaks without an instrument and without a letter. فالكفار لما يسمعون كلام الله يغلب عليهم الخوف والانزعاج والخجل والتضايق والقلق. And so the blasphemers, when they hear God's speech, they are overcome with fear and disturbance and embarrassment and being bothered and being shook. وَأَمَّا عُصَاتُ الْمُسْلِمِينَ, and as for the sinful Muslims, فَيَكُونُونَ عَلَى حَالَيْنَ, they will be in two cases. قِسْمٌ مِنْهُمْ يُصِيبُهُمْ خَوْفٌ وَانْزِعَاجٌ وَقِسْمٌ لَا يُصِيبُهُمْ ذَلِكَ. One group of them are hit by fear and disturbance, and another group of them are not hit with that. قال المؤلف رحمه الله, the author, may Allah have mercy upon him, said, الميزان, the balance, or the scale, والميزان حق, and the scale is true, وهو كميزان الدنيا, it has the shape of the scale in this world. له قصبة وعمود وكفتان, it has a vertical pole and a horizontal beam and two pans. كفة للحسنات وكفة للسيئات, one pan for the good deeds and one pan for the bad. توزن به الأعمال يوم القيامة, the deeds will be weighed on it on resurrection day. والذي يتولى وزنها جبريل وميكائيل, and who's in charge of this weighing is Gabriel and Michael, the two archangels. وما يوزن إنما هو الصحائف التي كتب عليها الحسنات والسيئات, and that which is weighed itself is the pages upon which the good and bad deeds are weighed. So that's the Sheikh's preponderance of the issue out of different sayings. He could have said, Allah knows how they are weighed. And he could have said, and it was said like this, and it was said like that. But he selected one, and he said it with definitiveness. So that means that's his determination of what's correct here. وَمَا يُوزَنُ إِنَّمَا هُوَ الصَّحَائِفُ الَّتِي كُتِبَ عَلَيْهَا الْحَسَنَاتُ وَالسَّيِّئَاتُ, what it is that's weighed actually is the pages upon which the good and bad deeds are written. فَمَنْ رَجَحَتْ حَسَنَاتُهُ عَلَى سَيِّئَاتِهِ, so anyone whose good deeds outweigh his bad deeds, فَهُوَ مِنْ أَهْلِ النَّجَاهِ, he will be amongst the people of salvation. وَمَنْ تَسَاوَتْ حَسَنَاتُهُ وَسَيِّئَاتُهُ, and anyone whose good deeds and bad deeds are equal, فَهُوَ مِنْ أَهْلِ النَّجَاةِ أَيْضًا, he also shall be amongst the people of salvation. وَلَكِنَّهُ أَقَلُّ رُتْبَةً مِنَ الطَّبَقَةِ الْأُولَى وَأَرْفَعُ مِنَ الثَّالِثَةِ, but he has a lower rank than the first and a higher rank than the third. وَمَنْ رَجَحَتْ سَيِّئَاتُهُ عَلَى حَسَنَاتِهِ, and anyone whose bad deeds outweigh his good deeds, فَهُوَ تَحْتَ مَشِيئَةِ اللَّهِ, then he is under the will of God. إِنْ شَاءَ عَذَّبَهُ, if God willed, he will torture this one. وَإِنْ شَاءَ غَفَرَ لَهُ, and if he willed, he will forgive him. وَأَمَّا الْكَافِرُ, and as for the blasphemer, so all that's for the Muslim, as for the blasphemer, فَتَرُجَحُ كَفَّةُ سَيِّئَاتِهِ لَا غَيْرِ, his pan of bad deeds will be weighty and nothing else, nothing more. لِأَنَّهُ لَا حَسَنَاتَ لَهُ فِي الْآخِرَةِ, because he doesn't have any good deeds in the afterlife. لِأَنَّهُ أُطْرِمَ بِحَسَنَاتِهِ فِي الدُّنْيَا, because he was already fed for his good acts on earth, in the life, in the present life. And this here, لَا حَسَنَاتَ, it could be read also, لَا حَسَنَاتِ, الشَّرْحُ, the explanation, وَالْمِيزَانُ حَقُّ, the scale is real. قال تعالى, the exalted said, وَنَضَعُ الْمَوَازِينَ الْقِسْطَ لِيَوْمِ الْقِيَامَةِ, in the 47th verse of Surah Al-Anbiya, it means, we put the scales, we put the just scales for Resurrection Day. وَلِلْأَخْبَارِ الْوَارِدَةِ فِي ذَلِكِ, and also due to the hadiths that came about that. وَالَّذِينَ تَسَاوَتْ حَسَنَاتُهُمْ, and those whose good deeds تساوت مع سيئاتهم. Their good deeds are equal to their bad deeds. هم من أهل النجاة. They are amongst the people of salvation. لكن هؤلاء يؤخرون برهة عن دخول الجنة. But they shall be delayed for a time from entering the garden. ثم يدخلون. And then they shall enter. يكونون على الأعراف. They will be on the wall. على أعلى سور الجنة. On the highest wall of the garden. الجنة لها سور. The garden has a wall. يحيط بها. A wall that surrounds it. وسورها عريض واسع. And its wall is thick and wide. قال المؤلف رحمه الله, the author may Allah have mercy upon him, said, الثواب والعقاب, reward and punishment. الثواب عند أهل الحق ليس بحق للطائعين, واجبين على الله. The reward, according to the people of the truth, is not a right of the obedient that's obligatory on God. وإنما هو فضل منه, it is merely generosity from him. وهو الجزاء الذي يجزى به المؤمن مما يسره في الآخرة. And it is defined as the payment, the payback that the believer is paid, which pleases him in the afterlife. والعقاب لا يجب على الله أيضا إيقاعه للعصاة. And the punishment or the torture or the torment is not obligatory on God also to inflict upon the sinners. وإنما هو عدل منه, it is merely justice from him. وهو ما يسوء العبد يوم القيامة, and it is defined as what bothers the slave on resurrection day. وهو على قسمين, and it is of two divisions, أكبر وأصغر, greater and smaller, or major and minor. فالعقاب الأكبر هو دخول النار, the greater torture is entrance into the fire. والعقاب الأصغر ما سوى ذلك, and the minor torture is anything else. كأذى حر الشمس يوم القيامة, like the harm of the heat of the sun on resurrection day. فإنها تسلط على الكفار, for indeed the sun shall be unleashed on the blasphemers. فيعرقون حتى يصل عرق أحدهم إلى فيه, and then they will sweat until the sweat of one of them reaches his mouth. ولا يتجاوز عرق هذا الشخص إلى شخص آخر, and the sweat of one person will not extend to another person. بل يقتصر عليه, rather each one's sweat will be limited to himself. حتى يقول الكافر من شدة ما يقاسي منها, to the extent that the blasphemer says from the intensity of what he suffers, ربي أريحني ولو إلى النار, my Lord, relieve me even if by putting me in hell. ويكون المؤمنون الأتقياء تلك الساعة تحت ظل العرش, and the God-fearing believers at that time will be under the shade of the عرش, or in the shade of the عرش, under the عرش, in its shade. وهذا, or يعني in the shade of the عرش, they will be in the shade of the عرش. That's enough to say it will, they will be in the shade of the عرش. I said under the عرش, in its shade, take out under the عرش, just in its shade. Allah knows how far does its shade extend, and if they would be in its shade without being under the عرش itself. It's just what makes me realize that now is the translation, because It says, under the shade of the Arsh. So, I don't think we usually would say in English, I'm under shade. I think we'd say, I'm in shade. So, just the word tahta here, which usually is under, made come to my mind, under the Arsh. But it's not saying they're under the Arsh. If you translate the statement literally, it's saying they're under the shade of the Arsh. So, I'm just going to say, they will be in the shade of the Arsh. وهذا معنى الحديث. And this is the meaning of the hadith. سبعة يظلهم الله في ظله. There are seven that Allah shades in his shade. أي في ظل عرشه. Meaning, in the shade of his Arsh. الشرح, the explanation. هذا الحديث رواه البخاري وغيره. This hadith is narrated by Al-Bukhari and others. وَتَمَامُ الْحَدِيثِ And the completion of the hadith is سَبْعَةٌ يُظِلُّهُمُ اللَّهُ فِي ظِلِّهِ Seven that Allah shades in His shade. يَوْمَ لَا ظِلَّ إِلَّا ظِلُّهُ The day when there is no shade but His shade. إِمَامٌ عَادِلٌ A just imam, يعني a just ruler. وَشَابٌ نَشَأَ فِي عِبَادَةِ اللَّهِ And a young man who was raised in the worship of God. And he grew up like that. وَرَجُلٌ قَلْبُهُ مُعَلَّقٌ بِالْمَسَاجِدِ And a man whose heart is attached to the masjids. وَرَجُلَانِ تَحَابَّا فِي اللَّهِ وَاجْتَمَعَا عَلَيْهِ اجتمعا عليه وافترقا عليه and two men who love each other for the sake of God they meet yani they come together for the sake of God and they depart for the sake of God ورجل دعته امرأة ذات منصب things with a kasra منصب I'm not sure. Wa Jamal and a man that was invited by a woman with status and beauty. Taqala inni akhafu Allah. And so he said, indeed I fear God. Wa rajulun tasaddaqa bi sadaqatin akhfaha fa akhfaha hatta la ta'lama shimaluhu ma tunfiqu yaminuhu. And a man who gave a charity secretly to the extent that his left does not know what his right spent that could mean that whoever is on his left side doesn't know that with on he gave a charity with his right side ورجل ذكر الله خاليا ففاضت عيناه and a man who mentioned Allah in privacy And then his eyes flowed. وَيَلْتَحِقُ بِهِمْ أُنَاسٌ آخَرُونَ And there are other people who will be like them. ذُكِرُوا فِي أَحَادِيثَ أُخْرَى صَحِيحَةً They were mentioned in other authentic hadiths, meaning this is not limited to the seven types of people. فَائِدَة Benefit شهر التعبير عن الحساب بالوقوف بين يدي الله. It is famous that it would be said about the reckoning, that the reckoning would be called, if I translate the statement literally, standing before God, or one might say standing in front of God. ومعنى الوقوف بين يدي الله, and the meaning of what would translate as standing before God is حسابهم عند عرض أعمالهم عليهم is their reckoning when their deeds are displayed to them وليس المعنى أن الله تعالى يكون في موقف القيامة it doesn't mean that God will be present on the station of resurrection day يعني like to say he's a person ويكون الناس حوله and then the people will be all around him لأن الله تعالى ليس جسما يتحيز في مكان. Because Allah Ta'ala is not a body that is contained in a place. ليس متحيزا في مكان ولا جهة ولا في الفراغ ولا ضمن بناء. He is not contained in a place or a direction, nor in any emptiness or space or void, nor is he between buildings. ولا هو في هواء العرش, and he's not in the air of the عرش. ولا هو جالس عليه, and he's not one sitting upon the عرش. لأن الجلوس والاستقرار من صفات الخلق. Because sitting, يعني being seated, because being seated and dwelling are amongst the attributes of creations. وَاللَّهُ مُنَزَّهٌ عَنْ هَذَا كُلِّهِ, and Allah has exalted from all of this. لِقَوْلِهِ تَعَالَى, due to his saying, exalted is he, لَيْسَ كَمِثْلِهِ شَيْءٍ, unlike him is there anything. وَتِلْكَ الْهَيْئَةَ الَّتِي يَتَصَوَّرُهَا بَعْضُ النَّاسِ, and that form that some people imagine. من أن الله يكون ذلك اليوم في موقف القيامة, that Allah would be on that day in attendance at the station of judgment. والناس حوله, while the people are around him, يجتمعون للحساب, gathered for reckoning. هذه الهيئة لا تجوز على الله, such a form is impossible to be attributed to God. لأن هذه هيئة الملوك, because this is the form of kings. تحف بهم رعاياهم, this is the form of kings who are surrounded by their subjects. قال المؤلف رحمه الله, said the author, may Allah have mercy upon him, الصراط, the bridge. صراط means path. صراط means سبيل, path or way. والصراط حق, and the bridge is real. وهو جسر عريض, it is a wide bridge. ممدود على جهنم, it is extended over the surface of hell. ترد عليه الخلائق, all creations shall come to it. فمنهم, يعني it's from the reformed earth to paradise, and beneath it is hell. فمنهم من يريده ورود دخول, some of them come to it for entrance into hell. وهم الكفار, those are the blasphemers. وبعض عصاة المسلمين, and some sinful Muslims. أي يزلون منه إلى جهنم, meaning they slip from it into hell. ومنهم من يريده ورود مرور في هوائه, and some of them come to it to pass over it in its air. فمن, يعني they fly over it. فمن هؤلاء من يمر كالبرق الخاطف, amongst those is who passes by like a lightning bolt. ومنهم من يمر كطرفة عين, and among them is who passes as fast as the blink of an eye. وهو محمول على ظاهره بغير تأويل, and this is taken by its apparent meaning. It does not have an alternative interpretation. وأحد طرفيه في الأرض المبدلة, one of its edges is on the reformed earth. والآخر فيما يلي الجنة, and the other is at the land of paradise. So the land of paradise means before getting to paradise, because paradise has its own land. Or if you want, it's at the landing of paradise. وقد ورد في صفته أنه دحض مزلة, It came in the description. It was reported about its description that it is unstable and slippery. وَمِمَّا وَرَدَ أَنَّهُ أَحَدُ Sorry. أَنَّهُ أَحَدُ مِنَ السَّيْفِ And amongst what was reported about it is that it is sharper than a sword. وَأَدَقُ مِنَ الشَّعْرَ And finer, يعني thinner than a hair. كما روى مسلم عن أبي سعيد الخضري Just as Muslim narrated about Abu Sa'id al-Khudri that he said بلغني أنه أدق من الشعرة وأحد من السيف It reached me that it is finer than a hair and sharper than a sword ولم يرد مرفوعا إلى رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم But this statement didn't come as a prophetic hadith وليس المراد ظاهرة And it doesn't mean its apparent meaning Doesn't mean يعني This description that was reported That's not confirmed to be from the prophet himself It's not interpreted to be literal بل هو عريض Rather, the bridge itself is actually wide وإنما المراد بذلك أن خطره عظيم And merely what is meant by that is that its danger is great فإن يسر الجواز عليه وعسره على قدر الطاعات والمعاصي For indeed, the ease of passing over it or the difficulty depends on the obedience and the sins وَلَا يَعْلَمُ حُدُودَ ذَلِكَ إِلَّا اللَّهِ And no one knows the limits of that but Allah. فَقَدْ وَرَدَ فِي الصَّحِيحِ أَنَّهُ تَجْرِي بِهِمْ أَعْمَالُهُمْ It came in the authentic hadith that their deeds make them run. مَعْنَاهُ أَنَّ أَعْمَالَهُمْ تَصِيرُ لَهُمْ قُوَّةَ السَّيْرِ Its meaning is that their deeds become for them the power of their stride. الشرح, the explanation, معنى قوله دحض مزلة. And the meaning of what I translated as unstable and slippery, a amless, it means that it is smooth. تزل منه الأقدام, feet slip from it. قال المؤلف رحمه الله So that's the only explanation the Sheikh offered means he's saying all of this is self-explanatory it's clear doesn't need me to elaborate That's how a lot of الشرح القويم is the explanation of الصراط المستقيم الصراط المستقيم a lot of it is clear doesn't require long explanation if somebody wanted to if he has the knowledge then he could make a vast explanation from this Sharh al-Qawim. This matin can condense volumes of explanation. But the Shaykh, he didn't offer volumes of explanation for this, nor did Shaykh Samir, and nor did anyone else that I know of who did some explanation for the matin of As-Sirat al-Mustaqim. But it is ready for that. Maybe someone in the future, maybe some of the ulama in the future will come and give broad explanation for this. Allah knows. Al-Hawd, the author says, the basin. Wal-Hawdu haqqa, the basin is true. وَهُوَ مَكَانٌ أَعَدَّ اللَّهُ فِيهِ شَرَابًا لِأَهْلِ الْجَنَّةِ It is a place in which Allah prepared a drink for the people of the garden. يَشْرَبُونَ مِنْهُ قَبْلَ دُخُولِ الْجَنَّةِ They drink from it before entering the garden. وَبَعْدَ مُجَاوَزَةِ الصِّرَاطُ And after passing the bridge, crossing the bridge. And this is also here after crossing the bridge, that the basin is after crossing the bridge. That's the Sheikh's preponderance of the case. Because there's a saying that the basin is before the bridge. فلنبينا حوض تريده أمته أمته فقط. Our prophet has a basin, or يعني it's a lake, or it's a sea even, because it's so big. To which his nation shall come only. لا تريده أمم غيره. No nations of others shall come to it. Prophet said in the hadith that he shoos people away from his basin who are not from his nation. Subhanallah wa bihamdi. That means something. That really means something there. Yani, he shoos people away from his basin who are not from his nation means that there's going to be believers from other nations that are like one might say out of line. I don't mean by out of line like being doing wrong thing. I mean like not where they're supposed to be. They need to be directed. Not here. This is not for you. You have to go somewhere else. Subhanallah wa bihamdi. طوله مسيرة شهر وعرضه كذلك. Its length is the distance of a month, and its width is also. So that's like one of the oceans we have now on Earth. Very big. أنيته كعدد نجوم السماء. Its containers, its cups, or its containers, are like the number of the stars of the sky. شرابه أبيض من اللبن وأحلى من العسل وأطيب من ريح المسك. Its drink is whiter than milk and sweeter than honey and more fragrant than the smell of musk. وَقَدْ أَعَدَّ اللَّهُ لِكُلِّ نَبِيٍّ حَوْضًا. And Allah has prepared for every prophet a basin. يعني a pond or a lake or the likes of that. But Prophet Muhammad's is the biggest, as it is said here. وَأَكْبَرُ الْأَحْوَاضِ حَوْضُ نَبِيِّنَا مُحَمَّدٍ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمُ. And the biggest of the basins is the basin of our Prophet Muhammad صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمُ. الشرح, the explanation. روى البخاري في صحيحه عن عبد الله بن عمر أنه قال. Al-Bukhari narrated in his authentic book from Abdullah ibn Amr that he said, قال النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم. The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said, حوضي مسيرة الشهر. My basin is the distance of a month. ماءه أبيض من اللبن. Its water is whiter than milk. وريحه أطيب من المسك. And its scent is more fragrant than musk. وَكِيزَانُهُ كَنُجُومِ السَّمَاءِ. And its cups are like the stars of the sky. مَنْ شَرِبَ مِنْهُ لَا يَظْمَأُ أَبَدًا. Anyone who drinks from it shall never be thirsty again. قَالَ الْمُؤَلِّفُ رَحِيمَهُ اللَّهِ, said the author, may Allah have mercy upon him, صِفَةُ الْجَنَّةِ, the description of the garden. الجنة حق, and the garden is real. يعني heaven is real. فيجب الإيمان بها, it is obligatory to believe in it. وأنها مخلوقة الآن, that it is presently created. كما يفهم ذلك من القرآن والحديث الصحيح, just as that is understood from the Quran and the authentic hadith. وهي فوق السماء السابعة, it is above the seventh sky. ليست متصلة بها, disconnected from it. وسقفها عرش الرحمن, and its ceiling is the عرش of الرحمن. that statement وسقفها عرش الرحمن, that's taken from a hadith. وأهلها على صورة أبيهم آدم, and its people have the appearance of their father Adam. 60 ذراعا طولا في سبعة أذرع عرضا, 60 cubits tall, 7 cubits wide. That's 90 feet by 10 feet. I'm not sure how you do that in kilometers. 90 feet. What's that, like 45 kilometers or less, a little bit less? 7 cubits, that's 10 feet. So what's that, like 4.5 kilometers across or something? I think something like that. جميل الصورة, with beautiful appearances. جردن مردن, without body hair and without facial hair. يعني except eyebrows and eyelashes and the hair of their heads. That's all. في عمري 33 عاما, with the age of 33 years. خالدون فيها, immortals therein. لا يخرجون منها أبدا, never leaving from there ever. Like they don't say, hey, let's step back outside of paradise. Let's go to the door and go out. They never leave out of there. وقد صح الحديث بأن أهل الجنة على صورة أبيهم آدم. The hadith that the people of the garden have the appearance of their father Adam, سِتُونَ ذِرَاعًا فِي السَّمَاءِ فِي سَبْعَةِ أَذْرُعٍ عَرْضًا, 60 cubits into the sky, 7 cubits across, is authentic. الشرح, the explanation. الجَنَّةُ حَقُّ, heaven is real. أي وجودها ثابتٌ, meaning its existence is confirmed. وهي مخلوقة الآن, and it is presently created. It is created now. ولها ثمانية أبواب, it has 8 gates. منها باب الريان, one of its gates is باب الريان. Or الريان, الريان, الريان. I'm not sure if there's شد on the ya or not. الذي يدخل منه الصائمون, that gate through which those who used to fast enter. وشهيد المعركة, and the martyrs of the battlefield. And the martyrs of the battlefield, وشهيد المعركة يخير من أي أبواب الجنة شاء أن يدخل. And the martyr of the battlefield shall be given the choice to enter into the garden through whichever gate he wishes. والجنة فوق السماء السابعة, and the garden is above the seventh heaven. منفصلة عنها بمسافة بعيدة, disconnected from it by far distance. يعني very far away from the seventh sky. ولها أرضها المستقلة, and it has its own land, its own independent land. وَسَقُفُهَا عَرْشُ الرَّحْمَنِ, and its ceiling is the عرش of الرحمن. So it's disconnected from the seventh sky. It has its own land. So that means that's its own realm there. وَسَقُفُهَا عَرْشُ الرَّحْمَنِ, and its ceiling is the عرش of الرحمن. So I'm saying ceiling, and when you say seal in English, it has the meaning of closed, being closed. You say seal it, so it has a ceiling, like the house has a ceiling. But it's the comparison of the arsh to the garden itself is like the comparison of the sky to the earth. It means here we are on the earth, and over the earth, there's something above us called Sama, sky. That's how the garden is. Over the garden, there's something. It's called Arsh, not Sama. كما أخبر بذلك رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم في الحديث الذي رواه البخاري. Just as the Messenger of Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam told about in the hadith narrated by Al-Bukhari, which is إِذَا سَأَلْتُمُ اللَّهَ فَسَلُوهُ الْفِرْدَوْسِ. If you ask God, then ask him for paradise, Al-Firdaus. يعني, if I translate Al-Jannah as the garden or heaven, then I would translate Firdaus as paradise, which is part of the garden. فَإِنَّهُ أَوْسَطُ الْجَنَّةِ, for indeed, it is the center of the garden. Paradise, the paradise, is the center of the garden. وَعَلَى الْجَنَّةِ, and it is the apex of the garden. It's very, يعني, if you have an idea of what that means, something very amazing. Because you have this garden so wide, wider than this earth by many, many, many times. Full of so much beneficial things. And trees, gardens, buildings. Some said there's cities there in paradise, in Al-Jannah, in the garden. Cities. And many, many things there. And it's basically saying the deeper you go in, like what if you're in the jungle and you go deep into the jungle, deeper and deeper into the jungle. So you're going deeper in there. So it's like the deeper you go in there means you're going in towards the middle. You're not at the edges, the outskirts, you're going inside deeper and deeper. So Firdaus is in the middle. So that means it's deep in there. وَعَلَى الْجَنَّةِ, and the highest part too. وَفَوْقَهُ عَرْشُ الرَّحْمَانِ, and over it is the عَرْش of الرَّحْمَانِ. وَأَهْلُ الْجَنَّةِ عَلَى صُورَةِ أَبِيهِمْ آدَمِ, the people of the garden have the appearance of their father Adam. سِتُونَ ذِرَاعًا طُولًا فِي عَرْضِ سَبْعَةِ أَذْرُعَ, 60 cubits tall, 7 cubits wide. حسان الوجوه, with beautiful faces. فمن كان في الدنيا من المؤمنين دميما, any believers who were in the dunya ugly, تذهب عنه دمامته, then his ugliness will go away. Because that's real, ugly. Ugliness is a real thing. Some people will say, nobody's ugly, everybody's beautiful. So those are some people that's... you don't want to listen to. Allah Ta'ala yaj'aluhu fil jannati kajamali Yusuf as-Siddiq. Allah Ta'ala makes them in the garden as beautiful as Joseph as-Siddiq. Yu'tihi shabahan bi Yusuf. Hold on. يعطيه شبها بيوسف الصديق في الجمال. Allah gives him likeness to Joseph in beauty. والذي كان قصيرا يذهب عنه قصره. And anyone who is short, his shortness will go away. ويجعل الله تعالى في كل واحد علامة تميزه عن غيره. And Allah puts in each individual a sign that distinguishes him from someone else. أَنَّ هَذَا هُوَ فُلَانٌ, that this is Fulan. حَتَّى إِنْ زَارَهُ مَنْ كَانَ يَعْرِفُهُ فِي الدُّنْيَا يَعْرِفُهُ تِلْكَ السَّاعَةِ, so that anyone who visits him and used to know him in the dunya would recognize him at that moment. فَإِنَّ أَهْلَ الْجَنَّةِ يَتَزَاوَرُونَ, For indeed, the people of the garden visit each other. وتزاورهم يحصل إما بأن يطير بالشخص سريره, and their visitation would be either by the person's furniture flying him there, حتى ينزل به أمام سرير الذي يريد زيارته, so that it lands him or takes him right in front of the furniture of the one that he wants to visit. فيجلسان متقابلين. So then they would be sitting across from each other. يعني those people in the garden, basically, they have very magnificent seats that they sit in. Their bodies are much larger than the bodies we have now. And they will be wearing silk clothing and having bracelets and having sandals. And they sit in these seats, and these seats will take them wherever they want to go. So if he wants to visit someone, his seat will just take him right to a person who will be in his own seat, and then they will be sitting across from each other. لأنه من سهولة السير هناك السرير الذي عليه لأنه من سهولة السير هناك السرير الذي عليه بمجرد ما يشتاق الإنسان لصاحبه الذي يريد رؤيته يطير به بقدرة الله تعالى. Because it is so easy there to go somewhere. The seat upon which one is, or the furniture that he sits on, his chair or his sofa or whatever it is that he's sitting upon. So sarir usually means bed. That's how it would usually be translated. His bed upon which he sits, or his seat upon which he sits, by his merely missing that person that he wants to see, his seat will take him there, will fly him there by God's power. Exalted is he. حتى ينزل به أمام سرير ذلك الشخص. Until it takes him right in front of the seat of that person. فيتجالسان. So then they both sit. فيتحدثان. And then they talk to each other. And يعني could be that more than one of them is talking to, يعني are talking to each other. So how do they do? So whenever he wants to talk to someone, he will face him. And when he wants to talk to the other, he will face him. So they, like that, they face each other. That means they won't be talking to the backs of each other's heads. So it means his seat turns so that he speaks to face to face with whoever he wants to speak to. ثم يطير به إذا أراد الرجوع إلى منزله. And then it will fly with him if he wants to go back home, because each person in the garden has his own home. وهذا هو معنى الآية. And this is the meaning of the ayah, the 47th ayah of Surah Al-Hijr, and also other ayahs. على سرور متقابلين. That means sitting upon seats facing each other. يعني never talking to the back of the head of the other. وأحيانا يركبون خيولا من ياقوت. And sometimes they would ride horses whose bodies are ruby. لها أجنحة من ذهب. And they have golden wings. تطير بهم. So it flies them. وَأَمَّا قَوْلُهُ تَعَالَى. And as for what God said, فِيهَا سُرُرٌ مَرْفُوعَةٌ. Therein, there are elevated seats or beds. 13th ayah of Surah Al-Ghashiyah. قَالَ ابْنُ عَبَّاسٍ. Ibn Abbas said, أَلْوَاحُهَا مِنْ ذَهَبٍ. These seats or beds have boards made of gold, mukallalatun bizabarjad, and they are adorned with emerald, wadurri walyaqut, and gems and ruby, murtafi'atun ma lam yaji ahluha, and those seats are raised as long as their people are not there. Yani, their default position is to be up. فَإِذَا أَرَادَ أَنْ يَجْلِسَ عَلَيْهَا أَصْحَابُهَا, and then when their people want to sit upon them, تَوَاضَعَتْ لَهُمْ, they bend down for them. حَتَّى يَجْلِسُ عَلَيْهَا, so that they could sit upon them. ثم ترتفع إلى مواضعهم إلى موضعها, and then when the person sits upon it, it rises up back to its tall position. And then when he's like that, he can just look down on the garden. Subhanallah, imagine being so high up and you're not afraid. Also, no fear. MashaAllah, who can't. وَأَهْلُ الْجَنَّةِ جُرْدٌ مُرْدٌ, and the people of the garden are without body hair or facial hair, except what I already told you. فِي عُمُرِ ثَلَاثَةٍ وَثَلَاثِينَ عَامًا, 33 years old. لَا تَنْبُتُ لَهُمْ لِحْيَةٌ, beards don't grow for them. وَلَيْسَ عَلَى, excuse me, وَلَيْسَ عَلَىٰ أَذْرُعَتِهِمْ وَلَا عَلَىٰ بُطُونِهِمْ وَلَا عَلَىٰ سِيقَانِهِمْ شَعْرٌ, and they don't have any hair on their arms or their stomachs or their shins. إِلَّا شَعْرَ الرَّأْسِ وَالْحَاجِبِ وَالْأَهْدَابِ, except the hair of the head and the eyebrows and the eyelashes. طعامهم وشرابهم لا يتحول إلى الغائط والبول, and their food and drink does not turn into feces and urine. إنما يفيض من جسمهم عرقا كالمسك, rather it flows from their bodies as sweat, like musk. ليس كعرق الدنيا, musk, it's not like the sweat of this life. عرق الدنيا يتولد منه الوسخ والقمل, the sweat of the dunya makes way for dirt and lice. وقد روى مسلم من حديث أبي هريرة أن رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم قال, and Muslim narrated from the hadith of Abu Huraira that the Messenger of Allah صلى الله عليه وسلم said, إذا دخل أهل الجنة الجنة, when the people of the garden enter the garden, نادى مناد, a caller calls out, إن لكم أن تحيوا فلا تموتوا أبدا, indeed, you shall have life, and so you shall never die. وَإِنَّ لَكُمْ أَن تَصِحُّوا فَلَا تَسْقَمُوا أَبَدًا, and indeed, you shall have health, and so you shall never fall ill. وَإِنَّ لَكُمْ أَن تَشِبُّوا فَلَا تَهْرِمُوا أَبَدًا, and indeed, you shall have youth, and so you shall never grow old. وَإِنَّ لَكُمْ أَن تَنْعَمُوا فَلَا تَبْأَسُوا أَبَدًا, and indeed, you shall have luxury, and so you shall never be in a bad position. You shall never be, yani, displeased or unhappy. وَآخِرُ مَنْ يَدْخُلُ الْجَنَّةَ مِنَ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ, And the last, وَآخِرُ مَنْ يَدْخُلُ الْجَنَّةَ مِنَ الْمُؤْمِنِينَ. And the last believer to enter the garden, لَهُ مِثْلُ الدُّنْيَا وَعَشَرَةُ أَمْثَالِهَا. He has, just for himself, as much as the world, as much as the world, times 10. وقد ورد في ذلك حديث صحيح رواه البخاري وغيره. An authentic hadith came about that, narrated by al-Bukhari and others. والله تعالى أعلم. Allah knows best. We'll stop there. Inshallah, after that, we'll continue reading the descriptions of the garden. And so we see Sheikh still has a lot to say here. Alhamdulillah. And then we'll move on to read the description of hell. And we'll move on from there. Do you have any question I can answer for you?